morning, and thank you, commissioners, for providing me with this time. Please excuse me, I had to write down my ideas to make sure that I said everything I needed to say to you on this, issue. It's not very long, but I'm going to read it. As you know, this resolution on corporate personhood and similar ones are being considered and passed by hundreds of local government bodies like the Sylva Town Council throughout the nation, calling for a new U.S. constitutional amendment that will overturn the 2010 Supreme Court's Citizens United decision declaring that corporations are people and corporate money spent on political campaign contributions is a form of free speech that cannot be regulated. Some have asked why this should be a matter of local government bodies to consider. The answer is that this Supreme Court decision and the institutionalization of legalized corporate personhood has had a profound impact on local communities and on their government's ability to effectively serve their communities. For instance, in North Carolina, because of the influence gained from the vast corporate political campaign contributions to state legislative leaders and the governor, the American Legislative Exchange Council, which is a conglomerate of extreme right-wing corporate interests in this country, like the Koch brothers and Art Pope, was able to write and muscle through passage of a law that limits the ability of local governments to review and improve local environmental regulations, such as limiting fracking, improving steep slope ordinances, requirements, protecting water quality and air quality. The same corporate political influence has resulted in legislation that takes money needed by local school boards and forces the school boards to transfer funds to charter schools and private school vouchers. The same corporate political influence has resulted in the state refusing federal Medicaid money available from the federal government that would cover medical expenses for 500,000 low-income and needy North Carolinians, including about 1,600 here in Jackson County, many of whom live in the town of Sylva. The same political influence has resulted in what many consider to be the most repressive voter ID law in the country that makes it difficult or prohibitive for many people in Sylva and Jackson County to vote, especially people who are low income and can't drive, minorities, students, and the elderly. These issues and more are the reason that five local municipal governments in Western North Carolina have already signed on to this legislation, to this resolution, asking our state government to join those states who are petitioning the federal government to create this new constitutional amendment to end corporate personhood. This includes the towns of Franklin, Bryce City, Highlands, Webster, and Forest Hills. In addition, last January, the Jackson County Commissioners passed this resolution to make this the first county in the western part of the state to join this national movement. Nationwide, to date, 542 local governments have passed similar resolutions. 11 states have voted to petition Congress for this constitutional amendment, and 9 other states are in the process of considering this petition. I hope today that the town of Sylva will join with these other communities and the county commissioners in standing up for the rights and needs of the people who live here, and for the sake of preserving the democratic principles of the nation for which we are a part. Thank you.
Thank you, Alvin. Anybody have any questions? Do you know how many local towns in all there are in the United States? What percent is 542?
Oh, it's a very small percentage of the number of towns, but this is an ongoing process, and there are people working in some areas on this issue and not in other areas. The point is we're trying to build up a movement to influence the states to pass a resolution to the federal government. And it's a slow, arduous process, and so 542 is a significant number. That means that many towns, there are people who are active on this issue. Pushing for it, which is a powerful statement, I think.
questions?
I will say that Barbara Hamilton, who isn't here today, she did express that she supported this resolution when I was passing it. She wanted me to let everyone else know in her absence that she was in support of it.
That's why I'm asking y'all, do you have anything that you want to do after his presentation? Do you want to vote on it or wait or?
I'd make a motion, I think we go ahead and vote on it.
Okay, all those in favor? Motion passes?
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
5:43.
5:43. And so you have a copy of that you will give to Paige?
I would.
Okay.